My name is Rich, and I just got this MyLOK device from the company II2P. What it seems to be is a password manager, and let's go ahead and open it and see what I got. All right, right away, I'm getting like a really awesome vibe off of this. This has got nice artwork. It looks like a really cool box. Everywhere around it, it seems to be password protection, secure storage, stuff like that. It's just a really cool box, and mine has 8 gigs because I ordered it early. Usually you're gonna get about 4. That's what it's gonna come with. And I've got about 20 passwords. That's quite a lot to me. I can't remember all of them, and I really wanted to try this out. New product, go for it. Let's go ahead and open this up, see this front flap here, and we get our first visual look at the actual MyLOK device. It's a USB token. It looks pretty slick. It's got like a gunmetal gray on it and a little bit of texture right there. Right here we got kind of a information flap. It says MyLOK is a smart chip based, easy to use, highly secure, completely portable password management solution. Easy, reliable, and secure. What I notice here is it says to activate your MyLOK, go to mylok.iitp.com. All right, so let's go ahead and open this box. All right, we're gonna tear it back here. All right, and the flap opens just like this. Looks like we got a kind of right here with the papers and all. Let's go ahead and take those out. I'm gonna set the box down so we can examine these papers. What this looks like is a quick install guide. Looks like it's got all the steps that I need to go ahead and use my MyLOK device. Let's go over that later when we actually open the device. And the other paper is a terms and conditions. So let's go ahead and get out the USB. All right, and here's the actual USB. Let's go ahead and take this out. It's kind of heavy, it's got a nice feel to it. Looks like they got their logo right there and MyLOK. Let's go ahead and slide this out. It's got a little slide. Just like that. I like the feel to it, and it just looks cool. So what we're gonna do is go ahead and use this quick install guide and put it in my PC. And right here it says recommended pre-installation guides. We must be connected to the internet and all our Windows needs to be updated. And we need to record our serial number before installation, located on the back. I'm just gonna write it on my quick install guide because I'm gonna have it right here with me. Okay, now I have my serial number. I'm gonna go ahead and insert the device. And it says a blue light will come on if it is inserted correctly, and it looks like this blue light has come on. And we're gonna go ahead and check my computer. And if you can see here, we have it created its own drive letter so that we can go and click into it. Now we're moving on to the back of the quick install guide. It says to open to view files and click on the MyLOK personal executive drive. So let's go ahead and do that. It looks like it's loading, and the next step also says that we're going to initialize the device. We have this little window down here that says the MyLOK manager is running, and to double click on the lock icon. And the picture on the quick install guide is the same as the one in here. Okay, now we see here the token serial number, which I wrote down on the front of my quick install. I'm gonna go ahead and enter that. And it prompts you to enter your security questions. It looks like you make up your own question and your own answer. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. There's also a second security question. Now it asks me to enter a PIN. I'm assuming that's how you get into the device. And I'm gonna go ahead and enter my PIN. And we're gonna go ahead and confirm this. A box appears that says the registration was successfully completed. And it prompts me for my PIN. All right, we have our first look at the MyLOK homepage here. And on the left here, we have a couple tabs displaying identities. Looks like we have desktop applications, web logon, configuration, help, and feedback. All right, so let's go ahead and see if this works and get a password saved. I'm going to go ahead and use Mozilla Firefox for this. Okay, right away I notice in the top right-hand corner, we have a new icon. It's right next to my home button. It looks just like the lock that they used in my system tray. It's got a purple background around it. So let's go ahead and click that. All right, it looks like we have bookmarks here. We're gonna go ahead and see if we can't register a credential, but they also have register split credential, auto login, and set new password, and they also have online help, which could probably be very useful. Let's go ahead to Facebook and see if we can't store a credential. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and type in my password. I'm gonna go back to this button in the top right-hand corner, and I'm gonna go ahead and click on register credential. All right, it pops up with a box here that looks like you can name your profile, add it to bookmarks, and give it a title. Let's go ahead and save this. It's gonna automatically add to my bookmarks. And I notice over here that the MyLOK device kind of blinks with the blue light, and that looks like it's working properly and saving the credential when I do that. So let's go back into Google. I wanna try this auto logon feature right here. I'm gonna go ahead and click that, and let's go ahead back to Facebook and see what happens. And it looks like it automatically logged me in, which is really awesome, and it looks like successfully stored my password. Everything works. If you wanna order one of these, I got mine off of mylok.iitp.com. It's pretty awesome of what I can tell. And that concludes our unboxing video. So I hope you all enjoyed, and see you later.